Okay. So for this video, I'm starting with a bowl that a pinch pot bowl that I've made previously. If you want to see how these bowls are made, you can check out either of the videos for the octopus bowl or the coral bowl. And there, I've shown in both of those videos how to make one of these bowls to start off with. Now, I started with a bowl of clay and have taken a bit off the top, so I am going to take a bit more off the top of this, and this is going to make the main body of my crab. So, ooh, that's a bit, possibly still a little bit on the large side, so actually let's take a little bit more off. Of a crab that I'm using here. So I'm going to pop that there and see. It's got quite a flat front. So I'm wondering what the best. There we go. And then it widens out to the sides. So I've got a nice kind of straight front here, and then a slight point in the middle of the back out to the outside edge. That's rounded. Now this is a very lovely smooth shell, so I'm smoothing top here, and then I'm just going to go around and gently soften the sharp edge that I've created by pressing down onto the tabletop. Down this bottom edge here so it's not as sharp. So my next thing is to put a little face in for my crab, so I'm just going to put a couple of holes off. Punch some eye sockets in, and then make a couple of balls that are the same size. Put a slip into the eye sockets and then pop the eyes in. These are probably a little bit big, so this is going to be a bit of a cartoony kind of look. Although there's a nice little edge of shell around each of the eyes, so I think I'm going to pop that on. A bit of extra slip. And just put a little coil over the top of the eyes like that. And then blend them in. The coil looks like it's part of the shell. There we go. And I'll do the same, I think, for underneath. just going to extend. Slit between the two corners a little bit further. And there we go, we've got some eyes for our crab. So that's my crab body. Now I'm going to put this onto my bowl, but the weight is going to take it so that it tips, and also I don't want my crab looking down so much, so I am just going to change the shape of my bowl so that I've got a bit of a shelf shape at the back here. And then I can sit my crab on there, like so. Now, I need two big crab claws. So I've got my flat piece that I have left over, so I'm just going to use this. So the claws curve, so I'm going to use the curve that's in this. And give myself use the shape from the curve to help with my claws. Now that's way too big for my cute little crab. That's a bit more like it. Even that's a bit on the big side, but so again, I'm rounding everything off. And crab claws are in sections. So I need to make sure that as I'm building these, I show the sections. Okay, I've got pointy claw on top, more such sturdy long one on the bottom, and then I'm going to build in the sections, so I'm just going to put a mark, press in so there's an edge to this part of the claw, so it's fairly obvious there's a section there, and then that's into the body. That's still quite a big claw for my little crab. I think I'm going to have to cut that down a little. That's better. Right, then I can use this one actually, so that I can get the scale right. two claws. Now it's just down to the rest of the legs. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 on either side. So I have 8 legs in total. Rolling up coils and then making the end so that it narrows down to a point and trimming so that all the legs are around the same size. Although actually the last leg might be a little bit longer. Because it looks like it curves. Curve slightly differently. So I've got these ones going this way and then the back legs go backwards. So I may need a slightly longer coil for that one. And each of these legs are in sections, so I'm just going to roll with the tool pressed down so that I get a line in each leg so that I have 3 sections. Simple legs. Now all that is left to do is a case of assembling, using the slip and blending things together, making sure things are positioned in a way that looks like the crab has a bit of character to it. So not completely straightforward, maybe slightly tilted. I'm going to pop these claws under the front of the crab like so. Gives me a bit more room for the other legs. finished. You can see I had to adjust the legs so that they would fit the bowl. They're kind of bent in, possibly a little bit more than is natural for a crab, but it keeps them safe so they're not hanging off the edge where they could very easily be broken. So I'm going with that instead. Oh, I think he's quite cute. So he's all finished. I hope you enjoyed that, and I will see you for the next video soon. Bye.